There are few slokas in Bhagavad Gita which are very authentic, which carries lot of loaded meanings. One such, in fact, two slokas from Bhagavad Gita are of 6th chapter, sloka 33 and 34. Arjuna uvacha, Arjun tells Krishna, Yoyam yogasdaya brokta, sam ena madhusudana, edasyaham napashyami, sanjalatvastitistiram. He says, if Atma is listening to mind, if Atma gives some orders and mind listens to it, and then it put into action by all the organs of our body, it's fine. That's what you say, it's a yoga. But the problem is the mind. Sanjalam ihi manah Krishna pramadi balavadrudam tasyaham nigraham manye vayoriva sudushkaram. Mind is so, it's like a tsunami. It doesn't allow you. You say that you do yoga. The problem is I am not able to control my mind. And my mind goes in all directions. And with this, I will not be able to perform the yoga. I will not be able to focus on the yoga and think about you. This is the state of Arjuna to Krishna. Please listen. There are many people who goes and then says that I am doing yoga. Yoga is something related to the mind. And Arjuna himself is not able to perform this. So what we do is only related to the physical body. Arjuna succumbing, Arjun accepts that he will not be able to perform the yoga to Krishna. So what Krishna says to Bhagavan uvacha asamsayam mahabaho mano dur nigraham chalam abhyasena tu kaundeya vairagyena sakrukhyate. He says, Arjuna, I will give you two options. One option is abhyasam, practice, practice, practice. Practice makes a man perfect. There is a saying. But please understand, if you are practicing something wrongly, it will make you, practice will not make you perfect, but practice will make you permanent. Practice will not make you perfect. So if your yoga is not performed by controlling our mind, which Arjuna himself says he is not able to, so whatever yoga we do, it is a physical exercise only. So come again here. He says, abhyasam, practice. Keep your Atman, the mind in me. Suppose if these karmendriyas are disturbing you, the eyes, the nose, the mouth and the ears, by listening to things which is not about God, seeing things which will not take you to me, speaking things which is not going to be of any Atma anubhavam or Atma tripti or Paramatma tripti, avoid. Use all your Jnanendriyas and Karmendriyas only to think about God. It is advice, abhyasam, practice. Think, speak, listen all about God. Slowly you will move towards me. This is abhyasam. He says, second option I am giving you is vairagyam. Detaching yourself from the samsara and attaching yourself to the God. Then Arjuna asks, what is the most ideal thing? Should I detach myself from this samsara and attached to you, or which is, should I give up this? Normally people say give up this and then attach, but Krishna here differs. He says it is very difficult for you to detach yourself from the samsara. Do one thing, attach yourself to me. Attach, saranahati, attach yourself to me. I will do this of detachment for you so that you come closer to me. This 33 and 34 of the 6th chapter is of so much of importance that it talks to you about two things, abhyasa, vairagya. So do not wait that thinking that, okay, I will detach myself slowly and slowly, then I will get attached to the God. Attach more and more here. He will see to it, paramana paravinai pacharuttu. He will see that he detaches us from here and comes closer to Lord Krishna.